What is up, everybody? Today is a big day, as you can already tell by the title of this video. The Cefiro is getting dyno tuned today. I'm super excited to see what this car puts down to the wheels. The car is currently running on E85 right now, but we're gonna go to the dyno, which is about an hour away from here. So let's get onto the road. It's raining a little bit, so gotta take it easy. This car is way too powerful for these roads right now. The roads are slick, so you gotta be careful with the amount of power in this car. You'll spin out real quick. And I just want to show you guys that I got the AC on full blast right now because all the windows are closed due to the rain. And this was my goal with the car, was just to have something really fast, but also just to... Thanks, navigation. But my goal with this car was just to have a fast street car with AC. It's extremely comfortable, you know, nice sound system. But yeah, man, the car feels amazing right now. It's so smooth. Not too loud inside here, just perfect.
Turn right, then you will arrive at your destination.
Just waiting in the rain because, as you can see, the gate is closed, and I'm waiting for the employee staff to get back here from lunch, and then I'll be able to get through the gate.
A few moments later.
What's up, little buddy? What up? As you guys can see, it's a shit storm out here. It's raining a lot, thunderstorm, but the car is now on the dyno. We're about to get a couple things situated. We gotta install the boost solenoid so that we can control the boost. So once Q, the wiring guy that you guys saw in my previous videos, he's about to be here, and we're gonna install some wiring stuff, and then we'll be able to start tuning. Just give you guys a quick look at the dyno facility. Got all the proper fans. This is only your front wheel drive or rear wheel drive, so can't do all wheel drive dynos here. And the type of dyno that they use is a dyno jet. All right, the man Q is here. You guys remember him from the last video, the wiring guru. He's gonna install the boost solenoid. And as far as the car, the fans are set up. Everything is pretty much strapped down on all four corners, front and rear. This is the boost solenoid for the Fueltech FT550. Q's installing it. Getting the boost solenoid installed. Any guesses how much power the car is gonna make? Again, it's on E85. Drop a comment down below. Let me know how much power you think it's gonna make. We got Alan and Aitan out here. Ichiban Engineering. This is Coach, the tuner, Fueltech tuner. Damn, that's sick. SR. So this chassis is super, super light. So, and this car is making almost 500 wheels. So this thing is moving. What are you guys doing? What are you guys doing?
A few moments later.
Yeah. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are just about ready for the first dyno pull. As you can see, we just completed the first pull. The car made 605 wheel with 841 pounds of torque. Holy hell, that is a lot of torque. But you can see the curve is so smooth, so linear, so that's a good sign. However, the issue is with all the torque that's being made, the tires are slipping on the rollers, so we gotta release some air pressure. And also, we're gonna throw some soda. Apparently, if you throw on soda, which has a lot of sugar on it, throw some soda onto the rollers, it's gonna help it stick. So that's what we're gonna do. Thai style, you want to stick? You put soda on the wheels. All right, let's get ready for pull number two. As you can see, the second run we did 642 wheel at 897 torque. Holy crap, almost 900 foot-pounds of torque. Smooth curve lines, as you can see. Incredible. Alright, after the second dyno pull, there seems to be a little bit of an issue with the TurboSmart 45mm wastegate. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have to pull off the wastegate and see why the car was over-boosting at 2 bar. And because the wastegate was not releasing any of the exhaust pressure, so we're gonna pull that off and see what's wrong with it. All right, so check it out. We got the wastegate taken off. Okay, let me explain what's going on right here. So the release valve on the TurboSmart wastegate is so tight, it's not moving up and down like it should. So what we have here is a floor jack with a couple bricks, and as you can see, the wastegate is over there. They're trying to compress the spring that's inside of the wastegate to release the pressure, and hopefully we can open up the wastegate and see what's going on with it. While they're over there working on the wastegate still, I want to show you what they're doing over here. So the Fueltech, the beauty about the Fueltech is they can do many different things. Right now they are calibrating all the sensors to make sure it is 100% accurate. And also we just installed the function for the left and right turn signals, so that whenever I use a turn signal, it shows up over there on the dash display. And the fuel tank gauge is also going to be showing up on the dash display, so I know how much gas is in the tank. They're just calibrating it to make sure it is 100% accurate. All right, we figured out the issue with the wastegate. What happened was air was not being released from one of the valves on the side of the wastegate, so air wasn't being released, and there was so much that's what was blocking the release valve from pumping up and down. But it should work now.
Many hours later.
As you can see, we are still out here. It is now pitch dark and we are ready to go. The car is warming up right now. And just for reference, so you know the temperature, it is 31 degrees Celsius, which is about 88, 89 degrees Fahrenheit. But let's get the show going. ladies and gentlemen, the best runs of the day. 782 wheel horsepower, 868 wheel torque. That's at 2 bar of boost. Absolutely bananas. Honestly, this is more than enough power for me. Yes, it would have been nice to hit 800, but shit, even 600 is a lot of horsepower for maybe 99% of the population to handle. So thank you to Coach Tuner, Ichiban Engineering, Wired by Q, Hyper Dyno, the whole crew out here. Unbelievable day tuning, and there were issues that arose, but the team came together and got stuff done, fixed the issues, re-dynoed, car made crazy power, 782 wheel horsepower, 800 whatever torque, crazy amounts of power. But that's it for today. Gonna call it a night, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace out.